Imagine a speeding object tearing through our solar system faster than anything we've ever seen. 87 kilometers per second. NASA called it a comet. But what if it isn't? What if this interstellar visitor is intelligent, maneuvering with purpose, and hiding technology that could change everything we know about life in the universe? Today, we're diving into the shocking discovery that has astronomers questioning everything. And the truth is more mind-blowing than fiction. The speed wasn't just impressive, it was alarming. Objects bound by the sun's gravity follow predictable rules, moving within certain limits. But 3IATLAS ignored those limits completely, as if it wasn't bound at all. That raised the first red flag for astronomers. Was this truly a comet? Or was it something else? Something with its own propulsion system? The discovery sent shockwaves through the scientific community. Some researchers compared it immediately to Oumuamua, the first known interstellar object, which also moved in ways that defied natural explanation. The similarities were too close to ignore, and the implications were unsettling. If 3IATLAS was moving this fast, not only was it interstellar in origin, it was also practically untouchable by anything humanity could launch to intercept it. Rockets, probes, even our fastest spacecraft would look like bicycles chasing a jet. At this point, speed was no longer just a measurement, it was a message. The universe had delivered something extraordinary into our backyard, and its behavior was already suggesting that this was no ordinary comet. Once the speed of 3IATLAS stunned astronomers, the next thing they looked at was its path through the solar system. And what they found made the mystery even deeper. Normally, comets wander in chaotic arcs, their orbits pulled and twisted by the gravity of nearby planets. Their movements may look dramatic, but in reality they're random. But 3IATLAS was different. Its orbital plane didn't just cut through the solar system at random, it lined up with the orbits of Venus, Mars, and Jupiter almost perfectly. During its close flybys, it passed within fractions of an astronomical unit of these planets, distances so precise that the odds of it happening naturally were calculated at around 1 in 100 million. Imagine rolling dice and hitting the exact same impossible number again and again. That's how unlikely this trajectory was. Even more unsettling was the way each flyby seemed to slightly adjust its path, almost as if it were using gravity assists deliberately, like a spacecraft slingshotting around planets to conserve fuel. For decades, that's how humans have navigated probes through deep space. Seeing a comet appear to do the same thing was suspicious. Was this just a cosmic coincidence, or were we watching something navigate with intent? Some scientists argued that probability alone wasn't enough evidence of intelligence, but others pointed out that the alignment, precision, and repeated close passes looked less like random chance and more like a carefully plotted course. In other words, this object wasn't just moving through space, it looked like it was choosing its path. And that single possibility was enough to change the conversation from astronomy to alien technology. If the speed and trajectory of 3IATLAS weren't strange enough, the next discovery left scientists more unsettled than ever. Careful measurements revealed that this so-called comet wasn't just coasting along on gravity's leash, it was accelerating. At certain points during its journey, instruments picked up spikes in velocity with accelerations ranging from 0.1 to 0.3 meters per second squared. Now that may sound tiny, but for an object hundreds of meters across and cloaked in ice and dust, it's far beyond what natural physics can explain. Comets can speed up slightly when their icy surfaces vaporize near the sun, releasing jets of gas. But those bursts are weak, irregular, and unpredictable. What astronomers saw with 3IATLAS was consistent, powerful, and strangely controlled. The numbers didn't match the profile of a natural comet. Instead, they looked eerily similar to propulsion, as if something deep inside the object was giving it a push, whether through hidden engines, exotic drives, or some other technology we couldn't yet comprehend. The comparison to Oumuamua became unavoidable. That earlier interstellar visitor also showed unexplained acceleration, leading some to suggest it was a probe disguised as a rock. Now history seemed to be repeating itself, only with an object even faster, even more precise and even harder to dismiss as chance. For astronomers, Every data point raised the same troubling question. What kind of natural body accelerates as if it knows where it's going? And if this wasn't natural, then what or who was guiding it? The idea of propulsion wasn't just speculation. It was the growing suspicion that 3IATLAS was not merely a visitor, but a vehicle. On the surface, 3IATLAS looked harmless, a glowing tail stretched for hundreds of thousands of kilometers. An icy shell glittered in the sunlight. To the casual eye, it was the very picture of a comet. But appearances in space can be deceiving. As scientists dug deeper, they realized the comet-like exterior could be the perfect disguise. Ice and dust, piled hundreds of meters thick, can mask whatever lies beneath. NASA's own studies confirm that even a single kilometer of ice can render a solid object nearly invisible to both optical telescopes and radar scans. That means if 3IATLAS carried a dense metallic core, or even something engineered, it would be virtually undetectable beneath its frozen shroud. It was, in essence, the ultimate Trojan horse. From the outside, it was just another visitor wandering through the solar system. But inside, there could be shielding, sensors, propulsion systems, or technology designed to travel unnoticed. And the disguise was flawless. No telescope, no matter how powerful, could pierce that veil. The possibility rattled the scientific community. If this wasn't just a ball of rock and ice, then humanity was staring at something intentionally hidden, cloaked in natural camouflage that made it look ordinary. It was the kind of deception straight out of myth, a gift horse that wasn't a gift at all, and the timing only made it worse. Just as questions about its true nature began to rise, the object slipped behind the sun, vanishing from our view completely. If something were going to make its move, this was the perfect cover. The illusion of safety was cracking. 3IATLAS wasn't just a mystery anymore. It was beginning to look like a message. A reminder that in the vast dark of space, not everything is what it seems. As if the speed, trajectory, and strange acceleration weren't alarming enough, 3IATLAS soon entered a phase that made scientists' skin crawl. It approached perihelion, its closest point to the sun. And in that moment, it vanished from our eyes. For weeks, the sun's blinding glare drowned out every telescope and every instrument aimed at the sky. Ground-based observatories couldn't see it. Even the space-based platforms like SOHO and STEREO were limited by the solar background. The object slipped behind the star like a magician hiding a card behind his hand, and just like that, humanity was blind. Normally, a comet's trip around the sun is predictable, and when it re-emerges, it follows the exact trajectory astronomers calculated. But with 3IATLAS, the blackout period created a chilling possibility. What if it didn't come out where we expected? What if, while hidden from view, it changed course? This solar blackout window was the perfect cover for undetected maneuvers. Any propulsion, any shifts in trajectory, even a complete change of destination could have occurred without a single instrument recording it. In effect, it had disappeared into the sun's shadow, free to act unseen. And when it finally reappeared, scientists were quick to notice its path wasn't exactly where predictions had placed it. The object was slightly off track, not enough to scream alien technology, but just enough to send chills down the spines of astronomers. Because tiny differences in space can mean deliberate choices. In that blinding window of silence, 3IATLAS had the chance to rewrite its mission. And humanity had no way of knowing what truly happened while it was hidden from the sun's glare. As news of 3IATLAS spread, scientists and the public began recalling a chilling voice from the past, Stephen Hawking. For years, Hawking had warned humanity about the dangers of shouting into the cosmic void. "If aliens ever visit us," he said, "the outcome might be similar to when Columbus landed in America, which didn't turn out well for the Native Americans." Those words were meant as a theoretical warning, but as 3IATLAS moved deeper into the solar system, they started to sound prophetic. For over a century, Earth has been leaking radio, television, and radar signals into space. From early Morse code transmissions to powerful radar sweeps tracking asteroids, our planet has been broadcasting a steady beacon of noise. Until recently, those signals were mostly ignored. But 3IATLAS, arriving with impossible speed, precision, and apparent intent, made people ask, what if something had been listening all along? What if our constant, uncontrolled emissions were not just passive noise, but an invitation? Hawking's warning was simple. Don't advertise your existence to a galaxy you don't understand. Yet that's exactly what humanity has done for decades, and now, here was an object behaving like a probe or a scout, sailing right into the heart of our solar system. Governments and space agencies began quietly reviewing old transmissions, trying to map where our signals might have reached and when. The coincidence was too eerie. An object from deep space, a trajectory that looked deliberate, and an entire planet that had been broadcasting its location for generations. It wasn't proof, but it was enough to turn a hypothetical warning into a moment of collective unease. Had we drawn attention we weren't prepared for? And if so, was 3IATLAS the first sign of a reply? For all the speculation about hidden technology and strange maneuvers, one fact loomed over everything. 3IATLAS was massive, and it was moving at an almost unimaginable speed. Astronomers began running worst-case scenarios. What if it wasn't a probe? What if it wasn't a scout? What if it was simply on a collision course with Earth? At 87 kilometers per second, even a modestly sized body carries catastrophic energy. For 3IATLAS, the numbers were staggering. If it struck Earth head-on, the impact would unleash an energy release greater than 10,000 megatons of TNT. To put that into perspective, that's hundreds of times more powerful than the largest nuclear weapon ever detonated. The consequences would be apocalyptic. Shockwaves tearing across continents, firestorms igniting entire regions, a rain of molten debris darkening the skies, mega tsunamis sweeping across oceans and swallowing coastlines. And beyond the immediate destruction, an even darker threat, a global impact winter. Dust and ash lofted into the atmosphere could block sunlight for years, collapsing agriculture and threatening the survival of nearly every species on the planet. Scientists were quick to clarify that, so far the probability of a direct Earth impact was extremely low. But the danger wasn't zero, and that tiny possibility was enough to keep planetary defense experts awake at night, because even a close pass at the wrong angle could disrupt Earth's orbiting satellites, cripple communications, or hurl deadly fragments into the atmosphere. For the first time, humanity was forced to consider not just the mystery of what 3IATLAS might be, but the terrifying reality of what it could do. Whether natural or not, its destructive potential was undeniable, and the question hung heavy in the air. Was this visitor a passive traveler, or was it carrying the power to end worlds? As astronomers processed the speed, trajectory, and hidden possibilities of 3IATLAS, they were forced to confront a question that no data could fully answer. What was it here to do? Some feared the worst. Could this be a hostile probe sent by an advanced civilization to test Earth's defenses? Its acceleration spikes, precise path, and ability to hide behind the sun all hinted at deliberate planning. If so, it might be observing satellites, studying human technology, or even gauging our planetary vulnerabilities. Every maneuver could be a test, and humanity might not even realize it. Others hoped for a safer explanation. Perhaps 3IATLAS was a friendly scout, a robotic observer sent to study planetary systems, much like Voyager or Pioneer, but far more advanced. Its purpose could be purely scientific, mapping, monitoring, and learning about our solar system without intending harm. If this were the case, we would be fortunate to witness our first interstellar visitor without suffering consequences. And then there was the possibility that 3IATLAS was nothing more than a natural but extreme interstellar body, an object ejected from another star system and passing through ours by sheer chance. Its speed, alignment, and strange behavior might all be the product of physics we barely understand. An extraordinary, almost impossible coincidence. The challenge was clear. There was no way to know intent from observation alone. Every scenario, from friendly exploration to hostile reconnaissance, required preparation. Every calculation, every model, every trajectory prediction suddenly carried weight far beyond pure science. Humanity was confronting a visitor that might be intelligent, or might simply be nature's most extreme experiment. But either way, the stakes were unprecedented. Speculation on intent wasn't just academic. It became the lens through which every movement, every measurement, and every broadcast from Earth was suddenly scrutinized. And the question that hung over every scientist, every engineer, and every world leader was the same. How do you respond when you don't know whether the object approaching is friend, foe, or merely a cosmic coincidence? As the implications of 3IATLAS became clearer, whispers began circulating about humanity's attempts to prepare. NASA was rumored to be running a classified initiative called Shield 3, a rapid response program designed for just this kind of high-speed interstellar visitor. The concept was bold, even audacious. Could we intercept an object moving at 87 kilometers per second before it reached Earth? Early plans suggested launching a spacecraft, possibly armed with a nuclear payload, to alter the object's trajectory far from our planet, but the challenges were staggering. Matching that velocity with current chemical rockets pushed the boundaries of physics and engineering. Calculations indicated a delta V requirement beyond 50 kilometers per second, something that conventional propulsion simply couldn't achieve easily. Even if the technology existed, time was short. Launch windows were measured in days and weeks, and any delay could make an intercept impossible. Scientists were working around the clock, running simulations, plotting trajectories, and considering every contingency. One small miscalculation could render months of preparation useless. The situation became even more complicated on a global scale. The United States, Russia, China, and other spacefaring nations all had a stake in the response. Coordinating a multinational effort while avoiding panic, misinformation, and political maneuvering was like trying to perform surgery in zero gravity. Every plan had to balance secrecy with urgency. For the public, this remained invisible. People went about their lives unaware that a potentially civilization-threatening visitor was threading its way through the solar system, while scientists and military planners worked feverishly behind the scenes. Every calculation, every launch simulation, every contingency plan was a race against physics, probability, and time itself. Atlas was no longer just a scientific anomaly. It had become a test of human ingenuity, preparedness, and the ability to respond to a threat that could arrive faster than any of our defenses were designed to handle. As 3IATLAS sped closer to perihelion, the tension in the scientific community and among global leaders reached a peak. Every telescope was trained, every satellite on high alert, and every trajectory recalculated countless times. But despite all the data, one question remained impossible to answer. Was this visitor natural, or was it something far more intelligent? Its behavior defied expectations. Tiny deviations in acceleration, subtle course corrections, and precise planetary alignments suggested intelligence, but none of it could be confirmed. Humanity had never faced a scenario like this before, where every calculation and observation could carry existential consequences. In this uncertainty, the object became more than a scientific anomaly. It became a mirror, reflecting human vulnerability and unpreparedness. For decades, we assumed space was vast and mostly empty. Now, that assumption was challenged by an interstellar visitor capable of exposing just how fragile our technology, our defenses, and even our understanding of the universe really were. Every moment of observation, every measurement of velocity, every subtle signal carried weight. One small error in predicting its path, one misinterpretation of its behavior, could have cascading consequences. And yet there was awe mixed with fear. Here was an object from another star system, moving faster than anything we'd ever observed, threading its way past planets as if it understood the rules of our solar system better than we did. For humanity, the encounter was a wake-up call. It demanded humility, careful calculation, and vigilance. We couldn't yet know if 3IATLAS was a friendly scout, a hostile probe, or a cosmic coincidence, but either way, it forced us to confront our place in the universe. The mystery remained unresolved, but the lesson was clear. The cosmos is watching, and humanity is far from the center of control.